Hello, welcome to the Gadget Tube. Today I'll be taking a look at the new Mac operating system, El Capitan. Apart from the new features that I'll get onto in a moment, Apple have added quite a lot of updates under the hood to improve speed and performance. According to Apple, apps launch 1.4 times faster, app switching is 2 times faster. Apple have also added metal, and I'm not talking about what these computers are made of. It's something that goes on under the hood that they've added to their iPhones for a while now, which helps improve performance of their graphics. According to Apple, the graphics will be up to 50% faster and 40% more efficient. Okay, so on to some of the new features, and first of all, it's the Mail app. It's now easy if you want to just minimize a composed or open mail, and just switch back out to other emails if you want to grab some information, text or images to put in your new email. There's also tabbed browsing for mail so you can compose more than one email at one time. It's now a lot easier to add contact information or calendar dates that you've been sent through your mail as the Mail app will now recognize them. Now in the new Mission Control, you can easily drop apps into different workspaces and you can even snap them left or right if you're in a full screen mode. You can also do this by holding the little green button. The workspaces and the snap feature especially seem to mirror a lot of what Microsoft are doing in Windows 10. The only difference here, you can actually slide apps that are full screen and snapped. Now for those of you who actually use Safari instead of Chrome, there are some new updates that will be really welcome. Now it's really easy to mute all tabs to save yourself embarrassment of your laptop splurging out audio and you don't know where it's coming from. You can also pin tabs a lot like in Google Chrome, and you can also AirPlay videos within Safari to different devices. One app that has seen a lot of improvement is the new Notes app. You can now use rich text editing, you can add checklists and also include images within your notes. Great thing about the new Notes app is if you have an iPhone or an iPad, they all sync up really simply with your Mac computer. Now one feature I really liked, which I often find myself doing, is trying to find the mouse cursor, especially if I'm watching things and going back and forth between the laptop. This new feature allows you to quickly move left and right with the mouse cursor, and it'll actually enlarge the mouse cursor to show you where it is on screen if you can't quite spot it at first glance. The new Disk Utility app seems a lot easier to understand, very similar to when you plug in an iPod to iTunes and it shows you the amount of storage apps or music has. Disk Utility has this similar kind of interface now, probably just to make things easier for people to understand. The new Maps app has transit information to bring it more into line with Google Maps. And to tie all these new apps and things together is the new Spotlight. The great thing about the new Spotlight is the natural language search, which means you just type how you would say in real life. An example of this is if you just search documents in May, it will give you documents that were made in May. Similarly to Windows 10, Apple have decided just to optimize speed and efficiency within the operating system rather than putting out any really big new features. And I think people who are already invested in the Apple ecosystem, people with a Mac, will certainly benefit from those, and everything will probably just work that little bit easier.